What up, you guys? Slim here at Team Purple Panda, here to do another deck discussion. I got this one as a suggestion from J. Roy Card, so shout out to him. We're going to talk about a deck that I've actually never talked about before, nor have I ever played against it, but for some reason I have both of the main synchro monsters for. It's just weird. I did some research a while back on this deck when it first came out because my friend wanted to actually make it, and then, he decided not to, but it's a really cool deck. People don't know, we're going to talk about Watts. I somehow have the Watt Hydra and the Watt Chimera. I don't know why. I guess I pulled them. I don't remember. But basically, Watts are simple. They lock down the opponent, like, big time. People don't know, they can attack directly. Their main monsters are, like, Watt Giraffe, that pheasant thing, I think. They're all light based. I mean, stuff like that. What I do know about them is that they can attack directly, and the main ones like Giraffe and Pheasant, they have over 1,000 attack points. So, taking 1,200 directly kind of sucks, and taking like 1,000 directly sucks. And what Watt Giraffe, if I remember correctly, does is when it attacks and it inflicts damage, your opponent can't activate spells or traps until the end phase of the turn or something like. I think it's something like that. And I'm pretty sure it's end phase of the turn. And Pheasant, when it inflicts damage, can remove from play one face-up monster, I think, on your opponent's side of the field until the end phase. So basically, if they get their direct attacks in, you can't do anything. And what I've noticed when I did my research was that one of the ways they accomplish this is they summon a card called Watt Hopper, I believe is the name. I think that's what it's called. Yeah, Watt Hopper. And that thing basically makes it, I mean, it's zero attack, zero defense, but it makes it so your opponent can't attack like another Watt type monster or target it. So basically, you lock your opponent down with that, with the direct attacks that come out of Watt Giraffe, Watt Pheasant, whatever else you use. And it basically locks your opponent down to the point where they can't activate stuff. A monster's removed until end phase, and they really hesitate when attacking you because of the effects of all these monsters. Because if you can't attack while Watt Hopper's on the field and you can't really do anything, you're kind of at a loss. If people are wondering, what these synchros do, Watt Chimera, you have to use a Watt Tuner and another Thunder type monster. So people are wondering, what is this whole deck? It's basically Thunder and Light. It's kind of like the Battery Men were. And what Watt Chimera does is it also can attack your opponent directly. Apparently, like, all these monsters can attack your opponent directly. So it's kind of cool if you like to go on the offensive that way and bypass the monsters. If it inflicts battle damage from a direct attack, you place one card in your opponent's hand at the top of their deck. So basically, it has set your opponent one turn back effect, kind of like Ryza, except it hits the hand instead and puts it on the top, which I think is really cool, actually. I mean, you attack your opponent for 1400, make them send the top card of their deck to the graveyard. I mean, that's kind of good, in my opinion. I think that, stuff like that causes that much frustration is good. It just depends because a lot of people are wondering, what does like what exact what's like the big deal? Like, why are people like so worried? And it's like, what exactly do you do to, stop that? And I mean, you do have your traps and stuff, but if you're on lockdown to where you can't, target, deep prison targets, you have to use main mass destruction like Mirror Force, Dark Hole, stuff like that, stuff that doesn't target to get past these monsters. I mean, this deck hasn't taken off at all. I haven't seen anyone using it. And it's cool, some people use it, some people don't. And like I said, it just depends on your play style. Is it really what you do? Or I mean, it's one of those decks that people decide to use or don't, depending on like I said, just depending on personal choice. I don't see anything wrong with the deck. I just see it not having enough support. And back on what the other synchros do, Watt Hydra, same thing, can attack your opponent directly. You can basically remove a card from play. Let me see, remove from play, add that. Yeah, here's what you do. Choose one card in your deck. Oh, this is really cool, actually. Choose a card from your deck, remove it from play, and during your standby phase, activating the effect, you can add it to your hand. So that's pretty cool. So it's basically like a gold Sark that works a little bit faster, and it works with direct attacks. So that's basically what Watts do, you guys. They lock you down with Watt Hopper, Watt Giraffe, Watt Pheasant, anything that's going to, disrupt your plays. And what I like about this deck is they're all direct attacks, and they all bypass the monsters. And you know, that's pretty cool. I mean, like I said, they're not hard to stop. Use Mirror Force, use whatever else you want to use. But I mean, they're cool. I was fortunate enough to have the synchros here to actually understand what they do, because like I said, I really don't know what they do. And I didn't feel like pulling up Wikia to do all that shit, because like people said, it gets boring after a while, and I agree, it does get boring. It gets more entertaining to watch me try and struggle and figure out these cards than have me read the generic crap that's already been written online. But you know, that's my take on Watts, is that you know, they lock down your opponent, they attack directly, their effects trigger after they attack directly and inflict damage, and you know, you can lose cards in your hand, cards on the field, set you back a turn. And I mean, that's really cool. I mean, decks are cool when they can do stuff like that. I was also asked by J. Roy Cards to talk about two new cards that were coming out, a Watt Cancel and I believe it was Watt King Cobra. So basically, I don't think these cards are out yet, but if I remember correctly, Watt Cancel, if I remember correctly, is basically kind of like a solemn warning, solemn judgment for the deck, where I believe you discard one Watt monster and you negate the normal special summon and destroy it. So I mean, that's really cool. That's going to add a lot more versatility to Watts, because they'll have kind of their own judgment, but you know, you won't have to pay them any points, and you'll get to just recycle the monster back, like Pot of Avarice or whatever you use. But I mean, it really does hurt your opponent when you negate their summons. So that's what Watt Cancel does. And then I'm trying to remember, what did Watt King Cobra do? Oh, I remember it. I believe it's kind of almost like a, oh, what's my best example? I guess like a Sangen or something. You know, Watt King Cobra can attack directly, you know, as well. All these Watt monsters can attack directly, so that's what's kind of cool. They bypass the monsters, attack directly, and then you can add one Watt monster from your deck to your hand, I believe, is how the card read when I looked it up a little while ago. I'm pretty sure that's it. You know, correct me if I'm wrong, but it attacks directly. It can add a Watt to your hand. You know, those two cards add a lot of versatility to the deck for people who've been trying to run it. This way, you'll have a searcher, you'll have, you know, kind of like a solemn judgment, solemn warning that you don't have to pay life points for. You just got to ditch a Watt monster, which shouldn't be too hard since the deck is Watts. And you'll basically be locking down your opponent throughout the entire game. Cards that I suggest you run in the deck, like you did when I researched it, they say you should run cards like Honest, of course, because, you know, it can beef up your light monsters. You can add Consecrated Light so that your opponent can't bring out dark monsters. You can add, oh, Thunder King Ryo is a big one. Thunder King Ryo is important because it's light, it's thunder, it works, it meets the requirements. So, you know, just a really cool deck, you guys. It's nice to review decks that people don't know a lot about. And once again, shout out to J. Roy Cards. I hope this answers, you know, your questions about Watts. You know, I did the best I could from memory after researching it, you know, what they do. I hope this answers, like I said, your questions. You guys, leave me feedback if you run the deck. Let me know what you think about them. Do they have potential since they can attack directly? We haven't had a deck that's been able to fully just inflict your opponent with that much damage since regular burn decks. So let me know what you guys think. Leave your feedback below. Please continue to rate, comment, and subscribe. And thank you for watching.